And they're all screaming about money, shrieking about money. People are nuts about money, absolutely crazy. People are playing Powerball lotteries, which are sort of like the poor person's day trading. And day trading, I thought, was a lovely idea. I thought it was, I would gladly trade you Tuesday for a Saturday today. And now we have the new dollar bills on the street, which are just so bizarre looking. If you look at the old Andrew Jackson and the new Andrew Jackson, the only thing that you can conclude is that somewhere in the Treasury Department, there is a gay man. Who, like, looked at the old Andrew Jackson and went, oh my God, look at that hair. Okay, we need product, we need to build the whole thing up, I think. Make the picture bigger, put it off to the side, it'll be very feng shui. And it turns out feng shui is actually a Japanese word for gay man. And I think it's interesting, perhaps only to me, that this new global capitalism turns out to be just as godless as that old communism. Which might be a topic for a paper, not so much a series of jokes. You know, I hardly know anymore. But this dot communism, it has freaked out the religious people in this country. Not that they needed any help. Ooh, the fundamentalists. I love the story in the year 2000. Remember the Y2K? Evangelical Christians said that they were going to be taken up into heaven on the rapture. I thought, good. And goodbye. I thought we should have had going away parties. Stand on a hill and go, bye-bye. We'll watch your stuff. I thought we should have hooked up an evangelical family with a homeless family. And just as the evangelicals took off, they'd take the keys to their house and hand them off to the homeless family. No one listens. But if you were an evangelical, and you had been telling everybody for a number of years that you were going to be taken off into heaven on the rapture, and you were still here, wouldn't you be a little embarrassed? A bit chagrined, but they're not. They are bold as brass, as my father would say. I mean, they're like people who smoke on airplanes. You know, who come out of the bathroom with smoke billowing behind them and sirens going off, and they're like, no, I don't know what it is. They're out of control. And the Pope's getting ready to take the big dirt nap. He is. He's apologizing for everything. He's tying up loose ends. He's apologizing for everything. He came out with a new papal letter, a post-it, I don't know. And it was called Mea Culpa, Iura Culpa. And he apologized for the Inquisition. I'm sleeping better. And he apologized for the Holocaust, although it was a very mealy-mouthed little apology. No mention of that shrunken apple-head Pope Pius XII, little love the Nazis, didn't mention him. And my favorite was, though, he apologized for any part the church might have had in the oppression of women. Thank you so much. So I read the list because I thought there were some things that were missing from the list of apologies. For example, there were no apologies for bingo. No apologies for fashion gaffes over the years. Why does the Pope wear the Melita filter on his head? And no apologies for 2,000 years of pedophilia. You can learn about it in my new documentary, Touched by an Archbishop. Now, where I come from, which is the old blue Baltimore catechism days. Mm-hmm. And you know, the Pope is doing this new thing. He's offering indulgences now for different modern things. Like, he's offering indulgences now if you stop smoking. You get a certain number of indulgences. Indulgences, look at the Jews, they're like, what? When is this going to end? But see, I think Jews are co-Catholic. And Catholics are co-Jews. And what goes around comes around, and where they meet, that's Italian. No, but indulgences are these things you do to take time off purgatory time. A lot of days in the Catholic Church are a lot like double coupon days. So we offered indulgences if you quit smoking, which pissed off the Marlboro man, I'll tell you, who nailed up his 95 grievances. I'm sorry, that was a Reformation joke, and that just wasn't important. The thing that I want to know about is, what about Nicorette? And this is the kind of question that we would debate in our little first grade class. We debated the most arcane ethical issues in our little first grade classes. We were like Hasidic Catholic scholars. Well, she's chewing the Nicorette. This is good. It is an indication of the willingness to stop the smoking, the killing of herself. And yet, she is still ingesting the nicotine. I don't know. I hope it's not a sin, though, because I've been chewing some Nicorette. Actually, so much my whole face has changed. My jaw is like the jaws of life now. No, there was an accident on my street the other day. And I was able to go down and chew through a Volvo chassis. Where I come from, which is the old Blue Baltimore Catechism days, you couldn't just say you're sorry, you had to do some things. Isn't that right? You couldn't just talk the talk, honey, you had to walk the walk. So if the Pope is going to apologize for things, he's got to do some things, I think. And one of the things he could do is let the gay people march in the St. Patrick's Day parades. Which drives those old Irish guys crazy, doesn't it? Oh, no, we can't let the gay people march in the parade this year. Not again, no. They'll be wearing the little buttons that say, "Tongue me, I'm Irish." No. That little sign over there, "Suck my shillelagh." No. Carrying the big banner that says, "Cunnilingus is not an airline." But speaking of Irish, this was incredible news. The love child of Sandra Day O'Connor and John Cardinal O'Connor, Sinead O'Connor, recently came out as a lesbian, which I think might be the third secret of Fatima.